I'm Dave Koz, and this is Driving with Dave. To our cruise.
Man, thank you for having me. I am so excited to be on your cruise and working with you again.
It's great.
I miss working with you. This is beautiful.
And I have to say, just listening to your rehearsal, that your music is filled with so much life and so much energy. And I think that's one of the things that I love. I love what you do. I love, period.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Dave.
But the music itself, I think it's just so, some of the songs like, like, well, you know, my favorite, Lydian.
Yes, man. I'm very proud of that one. That's one of my favorites as well. Yeah. You know, it took me about a year to write that song.
How does it take a year to write a song?
I couldn't figure out the pieces. I had... I didn't know what to do with that. Then I had... I said, okay, that's a verse.
Did you know that those were going to be part of the same song, or you thought maybe they could be two different songs?
I knew it was the same song. It was just like, where does this go? What does this go? Mm-hmm. Okay, the little release part. That was that in the verse was kind of clear. I didn't know what to do with that. Mm-hmm. And the other section. And Lan Richards came to my house one day, the drummer. He says, no, man, this goes right here. This part is right here. This is the hook. And he put it together for me, Dave.
Wow.
It was crazy, man.
So, tell me about your songwriting, actually. I'm interested to know about that. Because when you're writing music, and you're in that space, and you put that hat on, is there always a guitar in your hand, or would you sometimes be coming up with song ideas in the middle of driving or something?
Well, I tell you what, man. Sometimes I dream of ideas. Ah. And if I don't get them and write them down, it's gone. But mostly, I have my guitar in my hand. I have my guitar in my hand, and I'll start with a groove. It's just a chord groove, chord vamp sometimes. Every once in a while, a melody. Like, Lydian was a melody. Mm-hmm. Beep, beep, boom. It was like, ooh, that's kind of fat. What is that? And I found a chord. And it sounded like an A minor, but it's like a D minor with an A in the bass. Uh-huh. Okay. It's not the Lydian scale. A lot of people think it's the Lydian scale with the sharp.
So, but how did you come up with the name Lydian for something that's not in a Lydian mode, if you will?
I grew up with six sisters, and I saw the power in women. And so that title means the beauty of femininity.
Really? Is that what Lydian means?
That's what Lydian means.
Really?
Yes.
I'm so glad that we took this drive, because I never knew about that.
Yeah,
it's my favorite Norman Brown song.
So I dedicate that to all of my sisters. Who used to put dresses on me when I was little.
How many sisters you got?
Six.
Six. Now you love a big family, I think, because you have six kids.
I have six children, man, and I have six grandchildren now.
See, it's a magic number.
Yeah, it is.
So how old are your grandkids?
My grandchildren are now, 13 months up to 13.
But to me, that doesn't compute, because you don't look old enough to have six grandkids. I mean, you don't look old enough to have six kids, let alone six grandkids.
What I do, Dave, is I take my energy back from them. I take it back and give it back. No. It's here's the secret. You start early. Mm-hmm. You start very young.
You started at 12.
I was a father
12.
When I was 15.
No, you were not. Really?
I was 15, Dave.
Which kid did you have at 15?
Norman Jr. Norman
so
Jr.
Now we're going to do a little math. How old is Norman Jr. now?
Norman Jr. is 40.
So your kid is 40.
How about that? That's amazing.
That's intense, right there.
It is. It really is.
To have a 40-year-old kid. How's he doing?
He's doing wonderful. He's doing rap music. He's making rap beats for rappers.
You have a lot of talented kids. Your bass player kid, Rochelle.
Oh, Keisha, man. She was West Point graduate, right? And served in Iraq. And
you
she
got to be so proud, huh?
I am so proud of her, man. She's amazing. I said, wow, baby, you're a bass player. When she graduated from high school, she says, no, Dad, I want to take care of my life. I don't want to ask you for money the rest of my life.
Now, that's the kind of kid you really you really want to celebrate.
And she has not since.
That's
yes,
amazing.
It's amazing. So she's doing great. But actually, my three daughters have put a group together. They call themselves Soul, Sisters of Unbreakable Love. So there's Keisha. Then there's Rochelle. Rochelle is a Berklee School of Music graduate.
Right.
Baby
Rochella
girl.
Plays which?
She plays piano and sings.
Okay.
Now, she still lives here in L.A. Uh-huh. And then my oldest girl, Lanika. Lanika's given me 3 beautiful grandchildren. She went to a Musicians Institute, same school I went to. And they have a singing group. They actually toured with me last year on the Christmas show.
Are you serious?
Yes.
So how was that?
That was...
Was it like a little bit of a pinch me moment? Or like, how did this happen?
Well...
I got 3 daughters on the road with me.
Yeah.
Doing their own thing.
A little bit of both of those. Right. And Rochella sang a duet with Bobby Caldwell. He was on the tour with me. It was great.
I heard about that show, by the way. I heard nothing but raves about that show.
Yeah, it was great. But it's wonderful, man. They're all talented. And they actually have these products going, too. Keisha makes body butter. That's what I use on my skin.
Wow.
It's all natural. She makes it in a few different flavors. Skin and hair. Lanika makes charcoal toothpaste.
What are like entrepreneur musician people that you're... That's amazing.
I am so proud of them, man. They really are. And Shella is working for corporate at Trader Joe's here. Mm-hmm. And doing her thing on the weekends. They're doing great, the boys. Quincy, he's the youngest. He lives in Hawaii. He's a rapper. He goes up and raps his tail off. This guy can rhyme like you wouldn't believe. And he's 2 children. And Roy is the techno guy. He's studying aerospace engineering.
And how old is he now?
Roy is now 24.
Because I remember Roy as being this kind of like, he was a kid that when we did that tour, a couple of summer tours together, I remember him being around. He was like a little small fry.
That's Roy. He's a big fry now.
He's a big fry.
He's a big fry. He's about 4 feet taller than me.
Are you
about
serious?
4 feet thicker than me. It's huge, man. He looks like a football player. But no, he's studying in Washington, D.C., and he's building rockets, man. He's sending me pictures of his rockets he builds and stuff.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's really...
So they're all over the place. They're all... It sounds like they're thriving, and they're all doing different things, and all, you know, being interesting people in society.
They are contributing.
They're contributing.
That's
contributors, which is what you do. And I just want to say here, as we wrap up our little drive, how much I truly appreciate you being a part of our cruise, and how excited I am to not just me, but all the musicians, all of our guests as well, how thrilled we all are to have you.
Thank you so much for the hospitality. Your hospitality is off the chain.
It really means a lot to me personally because of how far we go back and how much of a fan I am now and always have been of your music.
Thank you.
And the fact that we can do this together and have some fun and visit some really exciting places and hopefully entertain some people in the process.
That's right. That's right. We want to bring some smiles to the faces with our spirit catchers.
Yes,
that's what
exactly.
I call our instruments.
Spirit catchers. I'm borrowing that.
Yes.
I'm borrowing that.
It's a spirit catcher. Yeah. We catch their spirits and uplift them and elevate them.
See, you heard it right here first. There's a guy. He's a trendsetter. That's Norman Brown.
That's Dave.
Love you, buddy.
Love you, buddy.
Ah,
thanks for having me.
Go get out of here.
Okay.
Are you flying back to Atlanta right now?
Yeah, I'm going back tonight.
See?
I have a show there on Saturday.
He's on the way.